the next presentation is on the strategic growth of educational institution and its impact on the development of the region. And I request Mr. Mohin Devi, research scholar, Global Institute of Religious Studies, from Washington University of Agriculture, Technology and Science, Allahabad.
The paper or this research looks at the direct as well as the indirect role that educational institutions have on their local regions, specifically within 5 kilometer radius in which those institutions are located. There have been some studies conducted extensively. This study is an exploratory research limiting itself in the area of the 5 kilometer radius in which the universities are located. According to Allison, she says that university or educational institutions goes further beyond the traditional teaching, learning, and research into impacting the local regions in which universities such educational institutions are located. Goldstein also says the same thing. He says that universities have generally embraced the goal of economic development as a complement to their traditional missions of education, research, and public service. So it is against this background that I've coined the term or the title of this paper. Problem statement. It has been acknowledged by the economic world to have direct economic impact on their immediate surroundings by university institutions or by tertiary institutions or by educational institutions. Therefore, this paper explores whether the presence of educational institutions somewhat have significant impact in the local regions in which such institutions are located, particularly within the 5 kilometer radius of their location. There are 3 objectives for this study. The first one is to identify the job opportunities available in those locations in which universities or educational institutions are located. Second one is to examine the relationship between the presence of educational institutions and development within the local regions of such institutions, specifically within 5 kilometer radius. The third one is to propose a model for local region development. The hypothesis for this study is to, the alternate hypothesis, which we will know whether we're going to accept or reject, is to find the significant relationship between the presence of educational institutions and development in their local region. Methodology. 300 questionnaires were circulated, out of which two, three were properly filled. This presented a response rate of around 74.3%. I used convenient sampling technique. The 223 questionnaires were circulated to to faculty members, to students, and to business owners around two main tertiary institutions in Allahabad. From the 223, 158 were filled by students from seven departments. In the same manner, 35 were filled by faculty members from seven departments, and then the remaining 30 were filled by business owners around the locations of such educational institutions. Now, methodology. In order to test the internal consistency of the study, Trunchback alpha of 0.46 was realized to authenticate or validate the research findings. Also, the questionnaires were properly validated by, first of all, being analyzed by experts in the university before they were circulated. The findings. The total variance is explained at three stages. That is to say that the questionnaires that were circulated were analyzed using factor analysis. And 13 items were analyzed under these factor analysis. So from these 13 items, the total variance were explained at three stages. That is to say that three main factors were developed from the factor analysis. The three factors were extracted as they have eigen values greater than one. When we say eigen value, we simply refer to the fact that the factors were intensively spread. The three factors that were obtained were the presence of commercial activities and educational institutions, and then the last one is the presence of health and professional institutions. Commercial activities, educational institutions, accessibility to health facilities, Now, in order to analyze the information gathered, I use the multiple regression model to be able to predict the factors. So in here, the local region development is the dependent variable, and then the other three factors being the presence of educational institutions, commercial activities, and access to health facility were the independent variables. Now the R-square use, that is a predictive ability, explain 25% of the factors, of the three factors that were used to for this study. So the 25% here means that once we have a unit increase in the dependent variable, that is the present, that is the local region development. Once we have a unit increase in it, it is going to cause 25% increase in the other independent variables. So the coefficient of model, we have the beta values being showing that the presence of educational institutions have a high number of induced value, that is 0.645, as compared to the other two factors. Conceptual framework. Now this is the proposed model that was developed for this study. The presence of commercial activities were loaded under factor loadings of one. There were six factors that were loaded. Accessibility to health facility were also loaded under factor two. There were four factors that were loaded. And then the presence of educational institutions there were three factors that were loaded. The main paper has the factors. Because of lack of time, I wouldn't go into it.
But we realized that the LRD, this is representing 25% explanation of reliability with regards to bringing development in the local area of those, the local regions around institutions. So that is to say that educational institutions contribute about 25% as per this study in bringing local region development. Now, further studies will have to be conducted. This is an exploratory study, so further studies will have to be conducted to find out which other aspects or which other variables contribute to local region development. Finally, the job opportunities that were available around those institutions were related to shop assistants, business owners, service providers like stationery shops, retail shops, food and vegetable stores, etc. So this study confirms previous studies by Allison and Stanville University 2005 that indeed presence of educational institutions somewhat contribute to the development of local regions in which such institutions are located. Thank you.